Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. We are Aveline de Grand Pré. We are in Louisiana, New Orleans. We are an assassin. We have a mother who vanished when we are young. And we have, seemingly, a lineage now of belonging to a wealthy family, and we have been given the skills of business concerns. So we're an assassin, we're a businesswoman, and at the moment, we're kind of feeling our way through who the characters are, who our family is, and we've got this overarching mystery of where our mother, Jean, went. This is Assassin's Creed Liberation, ladies and gentlemen. I'm the Patient Wolf. I do hope you enjoy this episode. Give it a like. Give me a subscribe if you haven't already. And join me here as we unleash and unfurl the mystery of this, what looks to be, a wonderful game. The key to the problem, investigate how to infiltrate the governor's mansion.
You may put your mind at ease, monsieur. The cargo will be delivered on time.
I dare say thanks are owed to Saint Nicolas.
Or perhaps a guardian angel, monsieur.
Ah, Aveline. I'm sure it is not your old father's company that draws you here. I will leave you both to your private business.
Aveline, the documents you found aboard the rat captain's ship. I recognize the name. Rafael Joaquin de Ferrer, a known enemy. I don't know what his business is here, but we can be sure it's more than a simple larceny.
How can I help?
One of Agate's servant contacts tells us that he will attend a social soiree at the governor's mansion this evening.
I'll have my best dress ready. Or my worst. Fear not, Gerald. I'll uncover his true purpose.
In the meantime, may I suggest that you familiarize yourself with the governor's mansion? Perhaps discover a discreet way to enter?
Don't worry, Gerald. I will prepare well.
One more thing. There is a small house for sale near the governor's mansion. It would be ideal for a dressing chamber. If you wouldn't mind buying it.
Your wish is my command, Monsieur Blanc.
Excellent. A lot of flirting going on there, but a fair amount of standoffishness. I don't know if their relationship's been developed. We're going to investigate the mansion. We've sorted that little mystery there, but we've uncovered a shady character. I can't remember his name now. It was long, but he is a ne'er-do-well. We must discover what he's doing in Louisiana and what his intentions are with this fair town. So, within this game, we have three personas at present. We have this lady, we have an assassin, and we have a slave. Now, all these have their different perks and different restrictions, and notoriety being one of them. So, at the moment, we can't climb, but we can walk through the streets relatively unrestricted. And so we've got to buy these little bureaus, these little changing rooms, in order to... Ah, here we go. Little shack here. The Egg Blanc. Tavern, the Egg Blanc. In order to get changed where we need to. We can't change like Superman down an alley. We've got to find a dressing chamber. Our first dressing chamber, there we go. Okay, now we've got to get it changed into the slave persona to find out about this character. There we go, we've still got our Connor's tomahawk, but that be it. But at the moment we are notoriety free. Look at that. Hangman's noose, gallows. Kill witnesses to lower the lady persona's notoriety. Okay. Right, find a way into the mansion. Right. Who's this guy? So, Tail the butler, okay. Don't know if he's going to be interested in who we are. Use L to move into the blend with groups. Yeah, we're doing that okay. Oops, sorry. No, we can't get through there. So we need to pick up something to take in. Let's go around this way. Okay, we managed to circumvent that little area. Oh, sorry. You're pissed, mate.
Remember, we need these goods delivered to the south entrance just after sunset. Here, this will grant you access to the kitchen.
They're plotting something. The governor is plotting something, or someone is. Now we've got to steal the key to gain access. Okay. We've done it. We've done it. We've got the key. We've got access to this secret passage into the governor's mansion. But what were they plotting here? Let's see if we've got any more people to talk about. This captain we didn't hear about. So Carly was born in the 30s to a modest family in Spain and became a sailor. Hard work and skill soon made him captain, the upright servant of humanity devoted his life to providing safe transportation to political refugees. And everyone else we've heard about. Have we? Yes, I think we have. Okay.
Bonne journée.
Bonne journée à toi. Right, cut short Governor Dabadi's plans. Right, to gain entry into the mansion. It looks like we might be able to do it this way. Oops, a day's pace. Down here. We don't need to climb up here. Right, we are currently, we need to get rid of that notoriety because we have level one now. Wow. Government mansion is pretty cool. Interesting wallpaper. It's quite busy. A roaring fire. Painting of the docks. Find the governor's office and remain undetected. Well, we could do with our lady's outfit, surely. Because we could probably walk through this. Oh, there's a geezer coming. Okay. Oh, God. Okay, we're not so important to them that they see us immediately. We're level one. Now, I wonder if we're level one because we're immediately in a... Oops. That rises quite significantly. Okay, well, we're okay just walking through. They're interested, but not too interested. What have we got here? More naval paintings, a grandfather clock. Quite into this wallpaper as it goes, I have to say. Right, let's move past. Sorry, sir. Yeah, it looks like we can, as long as we keep moving, we're going to be okay. Yeah, I get really good vibes from this wallpaper. Sort of, you get very bright yellow, but busy. It's busy.
With the Spanish under our spell,
The company man will at last have the power to fulfill our true purpose. And if you provide us the labor, we'll ensure the errors of Santo Domingo are not repeated here.
I will do all I can to smooth the handover of the colony, and your mission will have all the workers it needs, provided you make good on your promise. Labor is in tight supply as it is, and I must remain in power as governor. Were our arrangement ever detected?
My, my, Governor. I fear the air of conspiracy has gone to your head. We'll make good on our promise, so long as your end of the bargain is kept.
Everything is under control. You can count on me.
Bueno. Then I shall away to indulge in your delightful soiree. Tonight, I drink to the death of the Brotherhood.
So he's a Templar, because he's got a little Templar emblem on there. He calls it the Company. He wants the death of the Brotherhood. He's bribing the governor, who wants to keep his status, in exchange for safe handover of a colony to those Spanish dudes. Okay, I'm gonna get you and counter you. This is a double counter. That's correct. Now we have this. Nice. Oh, couldn't get out of that. Could not get out of that. Right, you, my gentleman. Governor, I'm not long for the world. Here we are into the kill fog.
Why? You would sacrifice the good of the colony to a Templar conspiracy, Governor. I should ask you why.
The Order is the future. The Templars will keep our colony French.
The Templars will keep the colony Templar. Why does the Ferrer want workers? Tell me his plans and redeem yourself.
I know nothing of his plans. I was to send him slaves and vagrants. The ones most likely to rise up against...
Against those who would oppose oppression and claim the life that is owed them. Rest in peace, Gouverneur.
Le gouverneur est mort! Aux armes! Aux armes!
Right, we need to make sure we're not got here. So escape the governor's zone and become anonymous. Right, looks like this is the way. So the governor is not a Templar himself. He just wanted to keep things very French. So in the same way as the Templars in Boston were trying to, you know, use the discontent to their own ends, they're trying to do that here. Trying to have an uprising so they can get their way. They don't care too much for the causes of anyone but themselves, and they will use anything to their advantage to get the power that they need and manipulate the power they need. Oh, go to the bayou. We're an assassin. So let's go to this guy and see if we can lower this. I'm gonna go to this one over here because he seems to be. What's this? Here we go. 200.
It is going to cost you.
Okay, we're better now. We're still going to arouse suspicion, but only a little bit. Good to be back in our assassin's garb, though. Okay, we're going to the bayou. The river. I think the bayou is the river, right? It looks like we might be going out of New Orleans into the bayou. Okay, we need to find out more about this Templar gentleman. Did we get given a bit of a character profile there? This new guy. Or is it the guy that Gerald de Blanc was talking about in the last episode? Here we are. Raphael yes. Joaquin de Ferrer. He was born in, don't know, 1730s and sent to Cuba at an early age. Like Antonio de Ulua, he was a man of science who rose to prominence and responsibility overseeing excavation research. He died doing what he loved at Chichen Itza worksite. Okay. Are we responsible for that? It looks like he loves enslavement. More than anything. What are these? Are they just flies? Or they denote anything? I think it's hot. I think there's stagnant water about, so I think there's lots and lots of mosquitoes and flies and lots of unpleasant things. Okay, hold to activate chain kill mode. Okay. Use L to select your targets and mark them using the L button. Right, we can have you. 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 And then kill them using the X button. Exit by pressing. Oh, I don't know what happened there. It wasn't very chainy. Give me your money, you sweet, sweet guards. Sequence 1 earned. Full sync. 2 years have passed since Aveline disposed of Governor Dabadio. Quite quickly we move on. During that time she found no trace of the man called de Ferrer, yet his plans continue to threaten New Orleans' population. On we go. Through the annals of time. So, 1765, Louisiana Bayou. The bayou holds as many secrets as it does dangers. Wow. Looks like we combat reptiles.
My student. The hornet's nest grows. I retreat to safety, the better to observe and strike. I require your assistance. Use your gifts to follow my trail. May the lower guide you swiftly.
This looks like it might be our mentor. Search for Agate, that's it. I can see you. Hold to investigate. Some kind of mask. Yeah, Agate presumably is steeped in African culture of one nation or another. And he's using that to guide Aveline. Really want to get in here with risk of being got. Gosh, that sounds like Uncharted, doesn't it? That little, those little pipes. Right, more. I would like more. Let's go back here and see where it was trying to take us. Right, this way. Get up there? Ah, we've got the mini-map there. Really do not want to get in here, having seen what we saw. I imagine we'll have some kind of death roll animation where we can hopefully dispatch them with a quick time event. I'm not looking forward to the moment it happens. A bit like the croc in Arkham Asylum. Suddenly it just gets you. Ah, here we go. Find the last clue. I wish to get out. Looks like it's heading that way, right? Right, back here. Aha. Silly me. Okay, we've got a little dwelling here. This must be Agate's secret assassin hideout. Swamp Queen. Tree runs with 10 branches without touching the ground. So, this is our mentor. I wonder where he learned his trade. That seems to be a changing station we can use there. Yeah, sort of nestled in between these geological features. So he's well hidden. Seems like that might be the way he likes it. There is, however, I'm going to get that later. Or should I get it now? I'm thinking of doing this viewpoint. Let's do that before we speak to our mentor. Look at this. So he's steeped in some kind of African religion. He called it Loa or something like that. Must be there. His religion's god. I'd like to know what religion that is. Wow. There's an assassin symbol and lots of different trinkets, knives, documents, and that symbol again. Okay, up here we go. No. No. Yes. No, it seems like we're onto this one. Or it might be, we need to go further up. Let's do that. This is a beaut. Sit here. Synchronize. Wow, this is the bayou. Something over there. Don't know what that is. Well, that's, is that just around us? No, it's definitely over there. What are you? Glinting light. Okay, viewpoint synchronized in this area, 1 of 6. Right then, Agate, let's go and speak to you. False Makandal. Help the mentor run from his past.
Agate, you wrote of the enemy?
Yes. Deep in the bayou, a dangerous imposter spreads real roots. He calls himself François Makandal, my own mentor. The leader, the priest, the brother, to whose cause I devoted my life. He was put to death by fire. I failed to prevent it. Who is this imposter, and what are his affiliations? This you will need to uncover. But first, preparations. François Macandal was an expert in poisons. This blowpipe was his.
A fine weapon.
A single dart blown from a distance will fell a man. You may use this to your advantage, if you approach in stealth.
Okay, he's talking about his mentor that he could not prevent from dying. And is it his spirits he's worried about? Let's read about Agate. So he's born in 1720s on the Atlantic coast of Africa. The records aren't available. In 29, he was taken into slavery and shipped to San Domingue, now Haiti, where he was taken under the wing of revolutionary disruptor François Macandal. He joined the Assassin Brotherhood in 1738, following a failed poisoning attempt against the white colonists of San Domingue and Macandal's subsequent execution. Agate fled to Louisiana, a marked man, and hid in the bayou. Unable to exercise his own murderous tendencies, he soon manipulated, that word again, Aveline and Gerald into joining the Assassin Brotherhood and trained them to do his dirty work. So he has got to hide, and he's using his underlings to do the work for him. Very strange. Manipulated. Right, hold R1 to open the weapon wheel, select the darts, and select the fast poison. Hold on, fast poison. Equip, there we go. Now hold to auto aim and release. Okay, we've got to wait. Nice. Now climb the tree. So, free aim and R2 and shoot the ranged weapon. Shoot with a ranged weapon. Okay. R2. Got him. Dive into haystack. I use auto aim to shoot from the haystack. That's nice. Oh. Money. Receive money. Good. Now where do we go? Unsure as to where we go. Do we go at the top? Again? Trying to see it. I think it might be up the top, mightn't it? It's not very clear. Familiar with the base elements of the bayou. Okay.
The false Macandal gathers followers. They attempt to overtake smuggling operations on the bayou. To finance what, I cannot say. There is a smuggler, a woman named Elise Lafleur. She knows every bog and tangle of the swamp. Perhaps she could be persuaded to help.
I'm sure I can motivate her.
Good. When you get to Macandal, use your darts to approach. But remember, you will need to complete your mission using more direct means.
So what I don't understand is that I thought Macandal died. I've lost the plot a little bit here. So Macandal is someone we need to try and corner. I thought that was the name of his mentor, but maybe I'm just very wrong. Current memory. Let's try again. Let's look at the database, see if this Macandal character has been submitted. No. I will be filled in, I'm sure. My little mind will be nurtured through this. So we're going to go to the smuggler's hideout to understand the bayou a bit more. And this Elise Lafleur is the lady we need to convince to impart her knowledge. She's not going to do it for free, though, I imagine. I imagine being a thief, she's going to be in some kind of trouble. So we've got to look to free her from that. There's that glistening thing, so let's go and see what that is. Oh, we're in the bayou. Oh, it's a boat. It's a ruddy boat. I thought it was a chest.
We offer two choices.
You give up the river.
Or we take the river.
Or you suffer. Before you die.
Three choices, then.
You dare threaten me? You bracket-faced parasite, I've no more claim here than the dung beetles.
You'd best heed the lady. We have you outnumbered. Look around, old man. Your hired hands will flee at the first sign of trouble.
Aye, but the lady's temper alone could take on an army. And the swamp is no friend of yours.
Okay, they managed to get those aggressors back down. Who are these guys? That Spanish looking gentleman. So kill the thugs and remain undetected. Okay. There's a guy over up there. They really have got them surrounded, haven't they? Right, how are we going to get across here? Oh, yes, we can.
Stop right there!
Kill one guard using fast poison. Oh dear.
Who the hell are you?
A fine display of gratitude. I'm no enemy, if that's what you fear.
I fear nothing.
My name is Aveline. I seek the leader of these men. He calls himself François Macandal.
You seek him? To what end?
A final one.
Ah, then you are my kind of woman. Name's Roussillon. My partner in crime is Elise. Though I've heard her called otherwise.
Will you help me find their base? No one knows these waters as you do. In return, I'll restore your control of this territory.
We've invested years of work in this camp. Why would we need your help?
Four reasons, right there.
Would you not prefer to move your wares freely?
If you think there's only one base, you really do need me. Those louts are spread out thin as swamp gas.
It's settled then. Elise will help you find the blighters.
We've got to investigate and kill these gangs. What's that? That's locked, so we can undo that, so we can change. I don't think we want to be a lady at the moment. Maybe a slave would be better, I'm not sure. Right, let's go and speak to this dude over here. Can't remember what he offers. Oh, so he's a shop, isn't he? Pocket watches. Cartographer's copy pocket watch. Okay. I don't know what these do, but let's have them. Quest item. Let's have them both. That must come up later. So we've got cartridges, fast poison darts, smoke bombs. We've got lots of those at the moment. Small weapons. Quite happy with the tomahawk at the moment. Right, let's go and get this chest. Okay, we've got to restore their power in the area so they can move freely with their smuggling. Right, it's supposed to be here, but where? No. Up here. Come on. Okay. Right, that is a canoe. That's our dressing chamber. So we're going to get this canoe and we're going to head over to here. That's our aim. Not much. Interact. Here we go. Hold R2 to move forward. Hold L2 to move backwards. Steer left or right. That's easy. Like a car. Through these, I'm not looking forward to when we see those crocodiles. I really am not. Got an enemy over here. Just get under this bridge here. So I'm unsure who the officers are. They're not Templars. I think they're just local officials. Right, here we are. Disembark. Hunt down the mentor's enemies.
Did you bring a canoe? Or do you expect your gentle breeding to keep you from the alligators? Best take one of mine, then. And learn to use it right quick.
What do you think we'd be doing, Elise?
Smugglers. Such an ugly word. Even slavers are called merchants. Why can my title be Queen of the Bog? Protector of innocence. Paddling instructor. And champion of trade.
Too long to fit on a wanted poster. Tell me, when did your troubles with Macandal's men begin?
About the same time the Spanish governor arrived. Just a big old coincidence, I'm sure.
The Spanish governor. That is that Templar guy, right?
This is as far as the water will take us. They set up their base around a wrecked ship that ran aground not far from here. The other base is a little further along. There. I'll check out this base. You scout ahead. Oui, oui, mon capitaine.
Oh my days. This isn't good. Right. Right.
Whoa.
Right. Oh, I got bit. All right, okay. Now what? I missed out again. Just got me again. Right. Oh, right. There's a sequence here. Got him.
Glad I didn't put money on that fight. What a last. And barely a scratch on you. Now here's a pretty prize. An alligator egg.
I'd rather have the skin than an egg.
Take it.
Where's the nest? Over here. These are like feathers, are they?
Aveline! A woman among reptiles.
Takes one to know one.
Oui, that it does. Right then. If you don't run the bastard through right here, I'll meet you at the next base.
Okay. So we could earn a special reward with all the eggs. Looking forward to that. Right, let's go and deal with this base here. Kill the followers in 3 minutes. Oh. Oh, let's go round. How do we go round? There we are. Oops. Boom. Oh, swipey, swipey. Plenty of swipes for these guys. Right, loot the letter from the chest. This looks like an old slave ship, doesn't it? How do we get down there? Better way in? Yes, there is. Come on. Try and get through like this. There we go. So we've got money.
My faithful acolyte, the day of the sacred ceremony draws near. I am in want of nothing but more men to join our ranks. Gather the faithful and await my word.
So was that Agate speaking there about gathering the faithful? I'm unsure as to who that is. It's an old letter in a chest. Sorry I'm so confused. I should be regaling the story as I go, but I'm very slightly muddy. Anyway, we've got a quest from Agate. We have... using Elise de la Fleur to understand the area, but in return we have to give her control of the area as a smuggler. So let's continue that. Well, that's it for this episode, but thank you very much for watching, and thank you to my patrons who support this channel. And did you know, being a patron, you get to have a chance to vote for what game I play next. Also, every episode is on Patreon, ad-free, and well before it airs on YouTube. So if you want to watch the next episode now, before it airs on YouTube, head over to my Patreon. And if you don't fancy that, why not try another of my Let's Plays, featured on the screen now.